Namaste. Today we are going to do Ashadha Amavasya meditation. This meditation is a series of sidereal spiritual karmic healing meditations. Every new moon, Amavasya, and full moon, Purnima, we enjoy this travel towards a deep spiritual connection with time and stars. Every second, the time is moving. As the time moves, the stars move. At least from a karmic point of view. And in this earth, we are feeling the passage of time through the movement of the stars. So let's tune ourselves with the karmic process and become more aware of its purpose. Let's sit comfortably and easily. If possible, if available, with your spine erect. Let's become aware of the breath. Let's become aware of the surroundings. And every Om that comes, we open ourselves to be more integrated to our breath, to our surroundings, our mind, our body. Let the air come in. And out. Once again, it comes. Observe the flow of air coming and go. Initially, become aware of the material part of this movement. Some air that you can measure comes through the nose, and then some air goes out through the nose. Observe a natural movement of the air. Just like a live being, this air decides to come in . This air decides to leave. When we are not paying attention to this air, it still keeps us alive. The moment that this life started outside the womb, the air connected to our soul. This life force from the very first breath is supporting the desire of the soul to be alive in this body. Again and again, I'm aware of this life force that has temperature, that has rhythm, that has depthness, there is length there, a lot of characteristics. Let us consider here this prana, this life force, as a person. Endowed with qualities, with gunas. Within the center of the chest, a little flame is incarnating in this body, just like the final part of your thumb. A little flame is shining in the center of the thorax. When the air comes in, life force is brought into the body. When we breathe out, heat is donated to the environment. When we breathe in, usually the air is colder than our body. When we breathe out, usually the heat is donated to the environment. Let's become aware of this cycle. Prana donates us freshness. Our soul donates warmness. The external air restores freshness, and prana once again brings freshness to the body. Once again, the soul transforms this freshness in warmness. And the body donates to the external environment. Let's observe the stars. The stars donate freshness to the plant. During the night, the planet is enlivened by the freshness of the stars. It rests, it replenishes, and then the sun comes. The sun takes this humidity and freshness and transforms it into warmness. The warmness expands and dries. Life goes up and the soil goes dry. After the sun completes its divine function, the stars come back. Because it's warm, life on the planet can be refreshed. Water can be restored. Water being restored, soil gets moisture. And with the support of the warmness of the day, life can stand to the night and restore its humidity. And then the sun comes. Because the way there is water in the soil, the warmness of the sun can heat the planet. And the moisture in the soil sustains the growth upwards. To grow, some water needs to be transformed. And after this cycle of upward movement completes its turn, the night comes back. downward movement brings water downwards from the atmosphere to the soil and to the roots. Water is always moving upward, downward. Heat is always moving downward, upward. Once again, let's become aware of the breath. Breath is moving upward into the body, and downward from the nose. When the air goes up into the body, it brings freshness into the body. When the air goes downward from the nose, it brings warmness to the atmosphere, to the environment. Up into the nose, down into the base of the spine. Up from the base of the spine, downward from the nose. Similar to a number one. Up to the center of the skull, down to the base of the spine. Up from the base of the spine to the center of the skull, downwards from the nose. A fresh energy comes into the nose, and then it goes down through the spine. The base of the spine boils, and the warmness heats the spine. And go out after turning in the center of the skull. in the atmosphere. The downward movement from the stars brings freshness to the planet. In the human body, from the sky of the head, the stars shower freshness to the base of the spine. In the environment, the upward movement by the action of the sun warms the planet, enlivens the planet. In the human body, the Kundalini Shakti boils the prana and it goes up to the center of the skull. In the material level, the air comes in upward into the nose with its freshness. In the spiritual level, the prana brings freshness downwards from the center of the skull to the base of the spine. In the material level, the warm air comes downward from the nose. In the spiritual level, the energy comes heated from the base of the spine to the center of the skull. An electromagnetic movement in the spine. releasing freshness on the top to the bottom. Sustaining warmness from the bottom to top. Little by little, it might be a perception that this internal movement can transcend the physical counterpart of respiration. May seem that electromagnetic current is taking care of the spine. While the body keeps its mundane breath. Foundation of transcendence is the realization of this cosmic pulsation in the spine. The practice of this realization, cosmic integration is attained. By the attainment of cosmic integration, deep peace rests in the mind. In the womb of silence, a seed of light and properly come. Shivoham, 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 Shivoham. Shivoham, 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 Shivoham. Shivoham, Shivoham. Let's be thankful to the sky that showers humidity. The humidity of love. Let's be thankful to the earth that sustain the warmness. Namaste. If you feel like meditating more, or if you feel like lying down, please rest for like 5-10 minutes so that the experience that was lived in the spinal level can and become more stable in a cellular level. Can glue there. If by any reason you need to get up to go to the bathroom or something like that, do it in an easy manner, slowly, with your eyes 80% closed. And after that, you come back and rest. As we rest, we progress. Ah. As we progress, we sustain the benefits of this practice. In a more long-term manner. And if you are in the winter, or it's cold, please cover yourself. Let's become aware of the breath. Let's become aware of the body. Let's become aware of our feet. Ankles, knees, thighs. Tail, reproductive organs, intestine. Heart, lungs, throat. And head. If you want to stretch slowly from the tip of your feet to the tip of your hands, you can stretch to your left side and to your right side. Seated, you can just bend downwards a little bit. And rest your spine. If you're laying down, please turn to your right side. The knees come close to the chest. The right hand comes between the knees. The left hand comes below the head. The chin moves a little bit inwards. And we come back into the womb of Mother Earth. receive a nice hug from Mother Earth. And then slowly we move our head downwards so that the forehead is more facing the floor. We stretch our left leg and we use our left arm to bring our body close to the hip. The head is kind of hanging in the left arm. And we breathe in again and release the right arm. The right arm is closer to the body than the left arm. We bring the left arm close to the body, to the right knee. And we are almost seated. We move our left leg up, put the foot, the palm on the floor, and then how it's comfortable, you can just simply cross leg without no need to do any stretches to the knee. We bring our spine upwards and we make salutations to the Father Sky with our spine upwards. You can take your time here and then slowly and gradually open your eyes. Thanks for being in this meditation. And if you want to share this with anyone, please do so. Shreem Mahavishnave Namah.